Hello, Space Lab. I'm Matthew Kleban. I'm a theoretical physicist and an associate professor at New York University, and I'm here to answer your questions. The first question is, if the multiverse theory is true and other universes truly exist, let's say we had the technology to escape our universe and go into interuniversal space. Since time only exists because of the Big Bang, and there are other times in different universes, same as our own, then what about the area in between the universes? Does time exist there? That's a great question, but before I answer it, let me say just a little bit about time and the Big Bang. So first of all, the Big Bang is an instant about 14 billion years ago where the known laws of physics break down in what's called a singularity. And what that means is that we don't know what happened really at that time or before that time. And there are several alternatives. So one of the alternatives, and the one that multiverse theories predict, is that time, in fact, did not begin at the Big Bang, and we really can ask what happened before it. In the multiverse theory, the Big Bang is the formation of a bubble in another state, a parent state. So you can imagine that most of the universe is filled with a liquid, let's say. Let's take beer. So you have a giant volume of beer. And in beer, every now and then, a bubble will appear. And inside each bubble is a universe. And this whole structure, the beer, the bubbles, everything, that's the multiverse. But for each bubble, for the universe inside each bubble, the Big Bang is just the moment that the bubble appeared. It's not a singularity. The temperature and the density at the time the bubble appeared is very high, but it's finite, it's not infinite. And we can use not the very well-known laws of physics, but some slightly speculative laws of physics to make predictions about that time, about the time that the bubble formed. And in particular, we can ask about what's outside, and that's a reasonable question. Now, about time, there's one time which exists everywhere in the multiverse. And it exists in the bubbles, and it exists in the region in between the bubbles. But you have to bear in mind that ever since Einstein's theory of relativity, we've learned that time is a much more slippery and flexible thing than we used to think. Time is something that can run at different rates in different places. For instance, if you're far down in a gravitational field, like deep in a mine far below the surface of the Earth, time will run more slowly. Fewer seconds will tick off on a clock than if you're high up, like up on top of a mountain or out of the gravitational field of the Earth entirely. And that's something that's been tested experimentally with great accuracy. It's true. So it applies to the multiverse too, and it means that in different places in the multiverse, time is going to run at very different speeds. So there's one universal time, but it's running at very different rates in different places. The second question is, with the theory or fact that the universe is expanding, how does science determine the edge of the universe? And once the energy or forces which drives the expansion is spent and the universe begins to shrink, what is left in its place? The same void or nothingness before expansion? Thank you. That's another great question, and it's one that many people ask about. And the standard answer is that the universe actually doesn't have an edge at all. Now, there's two ways that that could be true. One of them is that the universe could be infinitely big. And what that means is that no matter how far you travel, no matter how far you go in any direction, you never come to an edge. There really is no edge. It just goes on and on forever. You might wonder how something that's already infinitely big could possibly expand or contract. But actually, there's a pretty good answer to that. For the whole thing to expand just means that every part of it is expanding. And what that means is that if you have two distant objects, say two galaxies that are far apart from each other, they're moving apart because the space in between them is expanding. So if you look around you, you're living in one of those galaxies and you look around, what you see is that all the galaxies you can see are receding away from you. And the speed with which they're receding away from you depends on how far away they are. The further away they are, the more space there is between you, and each part of that space is expanding, so the faster that distant galaxy is moving away from you. So that's how an infinitely big universe can expand or contract. The same thing can work in reverse. So that's one way that the universe could not have an edge. And there's actually another way, which is that the universe can be curved. And this is very hard for us to picture because our brains just aren't very good at visualizing curvature in three dimensions. What you have to imagine is that we are two-dimensional creatures and we're just not aware of the third dimension. It doesn't exist for us. We have no idea that it's there. But in fact, we live on the surface of a sphere, the surface of a ball. So we can only move around in two dimensions, forward and back, left and right, but not up and down, and we don't know that there's a third dimension. So this is a two-dimensional analogy, so it's not perfect, but if you can just manage to bump it up by one dimension, so now we're three-dimensional creatures, and we can't imagine that our three dimensions could be curved. But mathematically, it's possible, and that's the second way in which there might not be an edge to the universe. But having said that, sometimes there is, in some theories, there is an edge to the universe. And in particular, in the multiverse theories, the universe is inside a bubble that's itself embedded in this parent state, this parent vacuum, we sometimes call it. And in those theories, there's an edge. It's the edge of this bubble. And what we can say, scientifically, is that if that's true, the edge of the universe is at least 10 times further away than we can see, than the furthest thing we can see. And probably it's much further away than that. How do we know that? Because if the edge was closer than that, we'd see some traces of it in cosmological data, and we don't see any of those traces. So if the universe has an edge, it's really far away. But it's something that we could possibly detect in the future as cosmological observations get better. And as for what the universe expands into or what it leaves behind if it contracts, if it's infinitely big, then it really is everything and it doesn't expand into anything or leave anything behind as it contracts because it's already infinitely big. And if it curves back on itself, you can think of it as embedded in a higher dimensional, four spatial dimensional space, but you really don't need to. You can think of it as a self-contained thing that again just expands or contracts without having any space around it. But in the multiverse theories, where the universe is a bubble, it really does have something around it, this parent state. And so you might wonder, what is that parent state? And the answer is, it's something very unlike what we see around us. It's a boiling, violently expanding, rapidly changing state where the laws of physics would look very different. Every now and then, new bubbles appear, so new universes are created. Sometimes they may disappear. So all sorts of stuff is happening out there. It would be a very inhospitable environment for a human being to find themselves in. But it is something that we can understand using these speculative laws of physics. They make predictions about the physical characteristics of that state, and so it's a very good question, and it's something that we're investigating right now to learn more about it. Thanks very much for the great questions. If you've got any other questions for the next expert, please leave them in the comments below.